Hello friends, welcome to my class. Today we'll see the continuation of pulse topic, that is assessment and alterations in the pulse. So pulse assessment is nothing but we are detecting or checking the pulse when the patient is coming to the hospital. So pulse assessment is done during patient admission so that we can identify if there is any problem or what is the health condition of the patient, and also while discharge also we will be doing so that we can compare if there is any significant changes in the pulse. Okay, not only discharge, after giving any medicines, after any treatment, so frequently we keep on checking the pulse so that we can identify, we can compare the readings from the admission and after giving some medications or after giving treatment, what is the improvement, everything we can detect in the while assessing the pulse. And it is a common procedure which is carried out in the hospital, and it is one of the important nursing interventions. So whenever you are checking the pulse, you have to see that you are checking it correctly. If you have any doubt, you can reassess it as it is, as and when needed. And whenever there is any deviations in the pulse from the normal, so while checking the pulse, you will be checking the rate, rhythm, strength, tension, everything, all the characteristics of the pulse will be checked. And whenever there is deviations from normal, immediately that has to be documented. That means it should be recorded, and also it should be reported to the senior physician or higher official so that immediate treatment can be given. And the pulse indicates the patient's characteristics, that is how the heart is functioning, about the cardiac contractions and how the cardiac output is there. So mainly pulse will determine the patient's functioning of the heart. And sites for checking pulse is in the neck, it is carotid, in the upper arm it is brachial, radial, ulnar, and in the lower arm it is femoral, popliteal, posterior tibial and dorsalis pedis. Okay, so these are the sites of checking pulse. And coming to the locations of pulse, okay, so in upper limbs you can check the axillary pulse. This is located in the inferiorly of the lateral wall of axilla. Okay, so that is, you can see the person's finger is kept on the axillary area in the inferior of the lateral wall of axilla. You can feel the axillary pulse. Next is the brachial pulse. So it is located inside the upper arm near the elbow. Okay, so you can see the fingers are kept near the elbow. So inside means it is the medial layer, that is near to the patient's body. Okay, so in that area you have to check for the brachial pulse. And radial pulse will be checked near the wrist. So that is located on the lateral of the wrist. Okay, lateral means far from the body. That area is the lateral area. So lateral to the wrist, you can feel the radial pulse. And ulnar is same in the wrist, but in the medial area. Okay, that is near to the body. That medial area of the wrist will be checked for the ulnar pulse. And in the lower limbs, the area you can check is femoral pulse. So femoral is in the inner thigh at the mid inguinal point, that is halfway between the pubic symphysis and the anterior iliac spine. Okay, so when you rest your hand on the hip, you can feel the anterior superior iliac spine. So from that to the mid inguinal point, halfway between that area, you can feel the femoral pulse. So you can see in the picture where the examiner is keeping the hand, okay, that is near to the groins, you can feel for the femoral artery, and that is femoral pulse. And popliteal pulse, so it will be checked above the knee in the popliteal fossa. Okay, fossa is nothing but like at the back of the knee, you can see a depression like area, that is called as the fossa. So that is found by holding the bent knee. Okay, so you have to bend the knee, hold it, and at approximately 124 degree you have to bend it, and you can hold it with the hands. And the popliteal area, that is inside the pit, you can feel the popliteal pulse. So there popliteal artery is running, so that is popliteal pulse. And next is dorsalis pedis pulse. Okay, so dorsalis pedis pulse in the top of the foot. Okay, so that is on the dorsum area of the foot, you can see. So lateral to the extensor of the hallucis longus. Okay, so that is a muscle that is running. So you can, near to that you will feel the dorsalis pedis artery. So that area you will be checking for the dorsalis pedis pulse. And posterior tibial will be below the ankle. Okay, in the medial side of the ankle, 2 cm inferior and 2 cm
posterior to the medial malleolus. Okay, so malleolus is again a muscle. So roughly 2 cm inferior and 2 cm posterior to this medial malleolus, you can see the posterior tibial artery is running. So in that area, when you feel with your fingers, you can see the posterior tibial pulse. And in the head and neck, you can identify the carotid pulse in the neck area. So it can be palpated gently and while the patient is sitting or in lying down. So there are two carotid arteries, but two carotid arteries you should not palpate at the same time. So because there will be limitation of blood flow to the cerebrum. Okay, so it can be felt in the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Okay, so the muscle that is running in the neck is called as the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and in between there is a hyoid bone, and lateral to the thyroid cartilage you can feel for the carotid pulse. And next is the facial pulse. So this is located on the mandible jaw bone. Okay, so on the line of the corners of the mouth there is a facial artery running. So you can see the fingers kept on the mandible line. So in that area you can feel for the facial pulse. And temporal pulse is located in the temples. Okay, so temples is nothing but the temporal bone, and in front of the ear is the superior temporal artery is running. So in that area you can feel for the temporal pulse. Okay, so these are the site and location of pulse. And next, while checking the pulse, the equipment we need is only the sweep second watch. Okay, so usually pulse is checked with other temperature and respiration and BP. So it is a procedure, but for pulse we need only a sweep second watch. That means the watch that will show the seconds. Okay, next is the techniques of taking pulse. So for every site in the body the technique is same. So now I will be just telling about how to take the radial pulse. Okay, because it is mostly commonly used in the hospital. So whenever a person is coming, we immediately check the radial pulse. Okay, so this can be done when the patient is sitting or lying position, but whenever you do this procedure you have to make sure that the patient is in the similar position. Okay, so every time you keep changing the patient will get excited and that can affect the pulse. So you have to make the patient comfortable before taking the pulse. And patient forearm should not be raised above the level of the heart. Okay, so you should keep at the level of the heart while checking the pulse, so that you have to place the patient's forearm at the level of the heart. No, you should not raise the hand. And nurse should place the index, middle and ring finger. So we have to keep three fingers with the index and ring finger. We have to compress the artery which is located above the wrist on the anterior surface of the thumb side of the wrist. Okay, so at the thumb side of the wrist we have to use our three fingers with the two fingers, that is the index finger and ring finger, you will apply pressure, and with the middle finger you will be checking for the pulsation. Okay, so like that you have to check, and while checking you have to apply gentle pressure. Do not overly pressure because it can compress the artery and it can prevent the blood flow. Okay, so it can obstruct the blood flow. So while checking you have to note for the rate, rhythm, strength and tension of the pulse. So already in characteristics we have dealt about this. So you have to check for all the qualities or the characteristics of the pulse. And using a watch you have to count the pulsation 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So for 1 minute you have to keep counting the pulse. Okay, so you should not do like 15 seconds you count and multiply by 4. So like that you should not do it haphazardly. So 1 full minute you should count the pulse, and then you have to document the results in the vital signs chart. Okay, so this is the technique of taking the pulse. And after care, so once the pulse is taken you have to make the patient comfortable and tell the, also inform the patient about the pulse rate and what is the normal. So everything you can tell the patient, and also you can say that you can ensure the patient's health is being correctly monitored. Okay, so that is just you can give psychological support for the patient. Okay, and also if there is any abnormalities, immediately you have to inform to the attending physician, and also it has to be recorded in the nurse's notes. Okay, so this is the aftercare. Okay, coming to the special considerations, that is what all the precautions we have to follow while taking the pulse. So nurse must have a prior knowledge about the previous pulse recordings for comparison. Okay, so you have to, on admission, you must know what was the patient's pulse and how is the pulse for every time you are checking, and also the nurse must have the idea about the, so knowledge about the normal value range of the patients at different ages. Okay, so already infants and children, there is a change in the normal range, so you have to know about that. We have to get a knowledge about the pulse ranges in every ages, and any medical surgical history, abnormal findings of any vital signs and any current medication that patient is taking can also affect the pulse. So these knowledge about the history of the patient also should be there while checking the pulse, so that we have to know, like, if there is any deviation, what may be the deviation. Okay, so to identify that, we must know the medical surgical history and also the medications what the patient is taking. And exertion, like climbing stairs and also running, jogging, so any exercise can affect the pulse, so you have to rest the patient before taking the pulse. Okay, so if a patient is exercising, then it can show wrong results, so you must make the patient comfortable and rest before taking the pulse. And also, patient should not take tobacco, caffeinated drinks, alcohol, anything should not be taken 30 minutes prior to the procedure, because these again they can cause changes or affect the normal range of the pulse. So these are all the precautions you have to follow while taking the pulse. Okay, first, abnormalities in the pulse rate. It can be tachycardia. Tachycardia is if the pulse rate is more than 100 beats per minute. So that is increased heart rate is called as tachycardia. And bradycardia means if the heart rate is less than 60 beats per minute, that is decreased or slow heart rate. And abnormalities in the pulse rhythm, it is regularly irregular rhythm or irregularly irregular rhythm. Okay, so regularly irregular rhythm is the when you check the pulse, every beat will follow a regular pattern. Okay, like for example, there will be 3 regular beats with in between 1 missed beats will be there, but every time this will be repeated. Okay, and all the next beat, subsequent beat also, there will be 3 regular and 1 missed beat, that is called as regularly irregular. And irregularly irregular pulse is when the heartbeat is spaced very irregularly with no discrete pattern. Okay, that means there is no pattern, you cannot identify, like sometimes there will be beat, sometimes there won't be beat, sometimes there will be weak pulse, sometimes there will be strong pulse, so that you cannot identify any pattern, then it is called as irregularly irregular rhythm. And next, abnormalities in the pulse volume. So here there is bounding pulse, so that means the pulse will be strong, throbbing felt over the arteries. It is due to forceful heartbeat. Okay, so heart is beating forcefully. This mainly occurs during over hydration or more fluid congestion is there, then the pulse will be very strong. Okay, and weak pulse means it is difficult to feel a person's pulse. Okay, so there will be very weak or slow pulse, mainly in dehydration or in anemia or malnutrition or anything where the patient is not taking proper nutrition, or when there is lack of fluid in the body, then the person's pulse will be weak. And pulse means you cannot detect the pulse at all. Okay, so that means in when patient is having some chronic illness, when there is severe arrhythmias in the heart, then you cannot check, you cannot identify the pulse by feeling with your fingers, that is called as absent pulse. And next is abnormalities in the pulse pattern. So there is pulses alternance, that means there will be a pattern where there will be strong pulse followed by weak pulse. Okay, so there will be alterations, so one strong pulse then weak pulse, so like this there can be changes in the pulse, that is called as pulses alternance. So here it means that the patient's heart is difficult to do the function of systole. Okay, that means heart is not contracting properly, so it is difficulty contracting. Okay, next is pulses bigeminous, that means there is a pair of hoof beats within each heartbeat. Okay, so in one rhythm you can find in between there is one gallop like rhythm. Okay, gallop is like horse beat. Okay, like that one abnormal rhythm you will be seeing in between the beat, that is called as pulses bigeminous. And pulses bisferiens is 2 beats per cardiac cycle. Okay, so that is in one cardiac cycle is like one lub and dub. Okay, the closure of the AV valves and closure of the semilunar valves will complete the cardiac cycle. So in one cardiac cycle you can see two beats. That means when you keep the fingertips on the radial artery or any of the artery and you check, you can see two pulses for each heartbeat, then it is called as pulsus bisferens. Okay, next is pulsus paradoxus. That means during inspiration the patient's heartbeat cannot be felt. Okay, you cannot feel the radial pulse during the inspiration phase. That is when patient is respiring, when he is taking in oxygen, that is called inspiration. So in that period you can see the pulse is not present, that is called as pulsus paradoxus. So this can be due to some cardiac tamponade or increased pleural effusion. So anything where the fluid or something is obstructing the heart and the heart is not able to contract, mainly during inspiration the lung is expanding and it causes pressure on the heart. Okay, so because of that patient cannot feel the radial pulse during the inspiration phase, that is called as pulsus paradoxus. Okay, and dichortic pulse, so this is same as pulsus bisferens, but here it is characterized by two beats per cardiac cycle. One will be systolic and one diastolic beat. Okay, so in bisferens the also there will be two beats per cycle, but both are systolic. Okay, that is the contraction, the heart is contracting very fast, so double contraction like beats will be felt. Whereas in dichortic pulse, here also there will be two beats per cardiac cycle, but one will be a systolic pulse and the other will be a diastolic pulse. Okay, so that is called as dichortic pulse. So these are the abnormalities in pulse pattern. I hope you would have understood my class. Thank you for listening. Please like, share, subscribe and also click the notification button for regular update of my videos. Thank you.